In this video, you'll learn to do basic layer transformations using the 2D Transform Timeline effects. This is one of many compositing tools in the sequence. But if you need to do picture-in-picture effects or reposition a graphic, this quick and easy tool does the job. Let's take a look. I have imported the London Zone image file sequence as a matte container from the embedded alpha folder. This is part of the Getting Started download materials. In the sequence, make sure you navigate to the bus 1 segment. Ensure snap is on and ripple is off. Drag the London Zone graphic to the sequence and snap it to the layer above the bus segment. If the comp timeline effects was added on import, the graphic should key instantly. If it was off, you need to manually enable the comp timeline effects to key the graphic. If the key looks incorrect, this is because the graphic has a straight or pre-multiplied alpha. You need to ensure that the comp timeline effects is using the correct alpha setting on the segment. Setting the segment's alpha to unpre-multiplied should fix the keying issue. So if you are just layering a graphic or image over another layer, the comp timeline effects does the job. To do the basic repositioning, we'll use the 2D Transform Timeline effects. Select the top segment and press Ctrl Tab. This brings up the effects ribbon. Click the 2D Transform Timeline effects. By ensuring that 2D Transform is selected in the effects pipeline, the basic parameters bar will show some of the 2D Transform controls. Just to give you an idea, when using the axis controls in the basic parameters bar, scale the layer to 50%. Now there are limited amounts of controls exposed in the basic parameters bar, and you can do a lot with it. But to access all the controls that any of the timeline effects have to offer, click the editor button to go into the advanced editor. You will note that any values you changed in the basic parameters bar are also shown here. So the scale value is set to 50%. Now 2D Transform has the ability to move the segment in three dimensions, so you can apply 3D moves to a segment. However, this is not the main 3D compositor for Smoke. The main 3D compositor is called Action, and you'll see how it works in later videos. As I mentioned earlier, one of the purposes of 2D Transform is for quick and easy layer transformations. So let's move the scaled graphic into the bottom right corner. But before we do that, you'll notice we can't see the background. The reason for this is that you are only looking at the result of the 2D transform. The viewing menu indicates that you are looking at the result. The result view is mapped to the F4 keyboard shortcut. In order to see the 2D transform in the context of the layers and sequence, you need to look at the contextual view. In the Viewing pull-down menu, select Context and choose Primary Track. This is mapped to the Shift F1 keyboard shortcut. So you can toggle between these views to see your graphic in and out of context of the sequence. Now let's perform the repositioning. Using the on-screen widget, move the graphic to the bottom right of the screen. You can also refine the positioning by clicking and dragging on the X and Y position slider. If you know the exact pixel values, you can click on any slider and type the number in the calculator. So there is the graphic in the correct place. One last point I'd like to draw your attention to is the quality of the graphic or image after it's been scaled. Similar to other graphic packages, normally some kind of filtering is applied to the image when you make it bigger or smaller. This affects the clarity of the image, and Smoke is no exception. In both the basic parameters bar and the advanced editor, you will find the texture filtering. The default filtering is linear. To increase the clarity, choose one of the higher options in the pull-down menu. Please note that this is not a necessity for everything, and in some cases, it causes scaled images to shimmer slightly. Just use it as you see fit. Once you are done, you can exit the 2D Transform Advanced Editor. You can preview the result by scrubbing or playing the segment in the sequence. You can now select your segment and press Render to process the final result. The 2D Transform Timeline FX is capable of much more, and you'll see this in a later video. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.